great work you've had with your legislations. When we're talking about legislations, we're also going to move on to code of practice. Now, the institute you work for may already have some code of practice, and you've probably been involved with code of practice in your workplace, and they can involve anything regarding timekeeping, dress code, disciplinary, and if there's any conflict of interest. Now, we have these within education to ensure the quality of education and training is a high level. And the Institute for Learning also have 7 key characteristics, which would be great for you to have a little look at below. Okay, we're now going to progress on from legislation and code of practice, and we're going to be looking at meeting individual learners' needs. Why is that so important? Well, there are key reasons why it's important to ensure that we meet the learners' needs. So equal opportunities, differentiation, the course content and the program, ensure that all learners are included and who have identified required support. Now, if learners don't feel that they're challenged enough, they'll often get bored and become disruptive. But equally, if the challenge is too high, they can also become disruptive. Now, it's important that we recruit learners onto the right course to suit their needs and their wants, so that they feel valued, so at the end of the course program, they feel they've achieved of something of value that will progress and they will be able to use in their workplace. When people feel that they're included within the classroom, they're more likely to succeed and become successful and be more motivated to be engaged within the learning environment. Tummins in 2010 stated that differentiation can be described as an approach to teaching and learning that both recognises the individuality of learners and also informs ways of planning for learning and for teaching that takes these individualities into consideration. So how do we maintain this? Well, we maintain this through delivering ILPs, through one-to-one initial assessments, confidentiality, risk assessments, to ensure that you're approachable and engaging, and that should encourage questions. When learners ask questions, it's important you engage with those learners to ensure that they're motivated and they feel that their personal or individual needs are being met. And it's important that we meet these individuals' needs to ensure we create a respectful environment. And you can create that respectful environment by making sure that your environment is set out to suit the needs of the learners. And then we'll be looking at classroom layouts a little bit more in Unit C. You develop a rapport with your learners and a group. By doing that, your learners will have more confidence to speak out within the classroom environment, and they're more likely to ask questions to ensure their engagement level.